Dear students, myself Dr. Fatima Sultana, Associate Professor in Department of Zoology, JDB Government Girls College, Kota. Today we are going to discuss the topic Major Forest Types of Rajasthan. India State of Forest Report. According to the Forest Report 2019 released recently, shows an increase of 5,188 square kilometers of forest and tree cover across the country compared to the ISFR, that is Forest Report of 2017. As compared to the report of 2017 and today's report 2019, there is an increase of forest cover that was 5,188 square kilometers. Now, however, the report highlights that Northeast India continues to lose forest when compared to the Forest Report of 2017. So in as a whole in India, if we see across the country, there was a rise of forest cover. But if it was compared with the 2017 report, the Northeast India was losing the forest cover. The forest report also reveals that the forest area under the category recorded forest area in tribal districts, which are home to about 60% of India's forest, is decreasing as well. Tribals are always dependent on the forest. 60% of their livelihood comes from the forest. Now, these areas also have been recorded that the forest area is reducing in such areas. The report for the first time did an assessment of biodiversity for all states and union territories and found that Arunachal Pradesh has the maximum richness of species in terms of trees, shrubs and herbs, followed by Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Now, the Environment Minister Javadekar did, when he released this report to achieve the target of 33%, we are still far away. Today we are at 25% and we have to go to 33%. But still it will take time. Short period of 2030, the target that 2030 will be covered will fall short, because as there is a lot of witness that increase in all kinds of forest, whether it was very dense forest, moderately dense forest or open areas, is under stress. The human activities are causing deforestation, and protection to the forest or afforestation activities, tree plantation drives and agroforestry has to be increased to reach the target of 33%. Forest in Rajasthan. India has the highest forest in Madhya Pradesh and the lowest in Haryana. Rajasthan is ninth in place in the country in terms of forest area. The state has 32,649 square kilometer of the area, which is approximately 9.54% of the forest area, out of which the highly intensive forest area of 72 square kilometer or 0.02% and intensive forest area of 4448 square kilometer 1.30%. The highest forest in the state is of Udaipur, which is 33,118 square kilometer, and after that comes Chittorgarh. Minimum forest area is in Churu in the state, and after this comes Hanumangarh in Nagaur district. In 1894, the British government first created forest policy in India. New forest policy was created in 1952 after independence. It was revised in 1988, and according to this policy, forest on 33% of the country's land is necessary. As I have told you before, that we are still having only 25%, although according to the reports of 2019 Forest Survey report, the area has increased, but still in India it is only 25%. To reach 33% is a long way away.
The first state in Rajasthan, in Jodhpur, in 1910, the Alwar Principality, created forest conservation policy in 1935. After independence, Rajasthan Forest Act was passed in 1953. And Forest Department was established in the state in 1949-50, the year 49-50. Rajasthan government declared its first state forest policy on 8 February 2010. At the same time, Rajasthan became the first state in the country to declare the environment policy. The types of forest, according to the legal status, government has classified this forest area into three types: reserved forest, protected forest, and unclassified forest. In reserved forest, the forest comes under the direct supervision of the government. No public is allowed to enter, or collection of timber and grazing of cattle is strictly banned. Whereas in protected forest, these forests are looked after by the government, but the local people are allowed to collect fuel wood, timber, and to graze their cattle without causing serious damage to the forest. That is, with the permission of the government, they can use the forest products. Unclassified forests are those in which there is no restriction on the cutting of trees and grazing of cattle. 7% of the area is unclassified, whereas 55% of the forest area comes under forest protected forest, and 38% of forest is reserved forest. The forest of Rajasthan can be divided into four broad forest types: tropical thorn forest, tropical dry deciduous forest, bamboo forest, central India subtropical hill forest, and mixed miscellaneous forest. Tropical thorn forests are found in arid and semi-arid region of western Rajasthan, namely Jodhpur, Pali, Jalor, Barmer, Nagaur, Churu, Bikaner. So, by naming these areas, we can clearly get the picture of the climatic change conditions of this area. The climate is very dry, and according to the climate, the forest also depends on the climatic conditions, and the trees are adapted to such environment. According to the adaptation, thorn forests are found in these areas. These extend from western Indo-Pak border and gradually merge with the dry deciduous mixed forest of Aravalli Hills and southeastern plateau. The main species are Acacia nilotica, Acacia leucofolia, Prosopis cineraria, Caparis, etc. Tropical dry deciduous forest. These forests are mostly found in small patches in few parts of the state. The northern and eastern slopes of Aravalli ranges, mostly in Alwar, Bharatpur and Dholpur districts, are covered with this types of forest. Sporadic growth of certain species of dry deciduous forest is found along the dry riverbeds of Jalor, Nagaur, Gangapur and Bikaner districts. The main species found in this kind of forest are babool. The rare plant species which are found in dry deciduous forest of Rajasthan: bamboo covers about 2.5% of the area, occurring mostly in Chittorgarh, Udaipur, Kota and Abu Hills. Central Indian subtropical hill forest. These are most abundant in central India, as in Madhya Pradesh, parts of Gujarat and Maharashtra, and are found in Sirohi district of Rajasthan. Also mostly on the hills girding Mount Abu. These forests have semi-evergreen and evergreen species of trees. The vegetation of Mount Abu consists of many plants which are similar to the subtropical region of Himalayas. Around Mount Abu, they are well represented between 700 to 800 meter altitudes. And we all know that Mount Abu is a hilly station. It is known for hill station. the temperature is very cold over there, and therefore again the climate controls the vegetation. So depending on the climatic condition, the vegetation is evergreen. Trees are evergreen type of species and they are found on high altitudes. Mixed miscellaneous forest, these are mostly found in south, eastern and eastern part of Rajasthan, including Chittorgarh, Kota, Udaipur, Sirohi, Banswara, Dungarpur, Bara and Jhalawar district. Average rainfall in these forests is more than 60 centimeter and cover approximately 20% of the forest cover. These forests mainly have Anagostis pendula, Anagostis latifolia, Terminalia. Three types of Terminalia are found here, Albizia and many other plants. So we can see mixed miscellaneous forest in which a good variety of species and genus of trees are found in these areas. Because the rainfall is good in these areas, therefore the tree cover, forest cover is also good. Now according to the 2019 report, the canopy density in Rajasthan, very dense forest is 0.02%, moderately dense forest is 1.27%, open forest is 3.57%, scrubs 1.39% and non-forest area is 93.75%. So we can see that what is the ratio of non-forest and forest area. Any type, whether it is dense, moderately dense or open or scrub area. We can see the comparison that why Rajasthan is known for its dry zone. Because the non-forest area is too high. It is 93.75%. Very dense forest, it has only 77.81 square kilometer of very dense forest, and moderately dense forest, 40 to 70% is called moderately dense forest depending on the canopy density. There are 4341.90 square kilometer of moderately dense forest. Open forest, in which the land is more scrubby, it is 12,209.80 square kilometers of open forest is found in Rajasthan. Scrub forest, it is 10%, less than 10% canopy density is there, and the area is 4,760.04 square kilometers of scrub area, which is 1.39% of the geographical area. Non-forest area, the rest of the area, including all other lands except forest area, which is 93.75%, is non-forest area in Rajasthan. Now the various functions of forest, we all know that forests are the sinks of carbon dioxide. They provide protection against soil erosion, droughts, floods, noise, radiation. These are the protective functions. And productive functions are the NTFPs, non-timber forest products, like gum, resins, medicines, katha, honey, pulp, bamboo, timber and fruits. Accessories are, forest provides aesthetic habitat to various flora and fauna. Besides that, it also has an recreational value. As we are hearing about the Chambal biodiversity, it is going to be one of the recreational biological park in Kota, which comes under this accessory functions. Regulative functions, the forest regulates the level of oxygen and carbon dioxide in atmosphere. The forest also help in regulating temperature conditions. As I have told you, the type of forest depends upon the climatic conditions. The western area of Rajasthan has thorny forest because the temperature is very high, land is sandy, and water is too less. There are no rivers over there. All these conditions caused and shows the presence of the type of vegetation found in that particular area. And forest, they are the sinks of carbon dioxide. They are the ones which gives us oxygen. So they regulate the level of oxygen and carbon dioxide in atmosphere. Ecological importance or uses of forest are reduction of global warming. They help in climatic conditions. Global warming, why we are seeing this global warming, that it is increasing? Because of the deforestation. The main greenhouse gas, carbon dioxide, is used by forest for photosynthesis process. The forest act as sink for carbon dioxide, thereby reducing the greenhouse effect due to carbon dioxide. As the trees are going less, deforestation is increasing. This carbon dioxide, which is being produced as a pollutant, is increasing the level of temperature. Forest also helps in conservation of soil. They prevent soil erosion by binding the soil particles tightly in their roots. They also reduce the velocity of wind and rain, which are chief agents that cause erosion. Production of oxygen. As we know that trees are the only ones which can give oxygen, because by the process of photosynthesis, they use carbon dioxide, water and sunlight to produce oxygen. So during photosynthesis process, forest releases oxygen, a very important gas for human survival, thereby are called as lungs of heart. Forests are lungs of our earth. Regulation of global climate and temperature. Forest plays a crucial role in regulation of global climate and temperature, as forest cover absorbs the solar radiations that would otherwise be reflected back into the atmosphere by bare surface of the earth. Transpiration of plant increases the atmosphere humidity, which affects the rainfall, cools the atmosphere and thus regulates the hydrological cycle. So we see that how forests are important for us. They are regulating each and everything which is essential for human growth. But what we are doing? The population of human is rising and the forest is reducing. Therefore, we are seeing this negative impacts, which are the natural disasters. They are coming in the form of natural disasters, in the form of tsunami, in the form of floods, in the form of cyclones. All what we are facing is created by human. We are the ones responsible for this global warming. So awareness programs are very important. Plantation, afforestation, such drives are very important to increase the forest area, and to reach 33% is a long way which we have to patiently prove ourselves that we can do it, and all together we can do it. The other economical importance of forest are the timber, fuel wood, raw material of wood-based industries. All the wood, it comes from forest. But cutting trees is not a good purpose. Fruits, roots, leaves, plants, all this comes from forest. Even animals get food from this forest. Tribals, 60% of the livelihood is based on the forest. Other miscellaneous products are resins, gums, oils, medicines, katha, honey, etc., which comes from forest. Thank you so much.